Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today I have prepared three true-false questions for you, or statements, and here is the first statement. DNA replication proceeds only in one direction. Is it true or false? And if you don't know how to answer this question, here is my explanation. So imagine that this is bacterial only chromosome, and bacteria has circular chromosome, and of course it is double-stranded. So here is the two strands of this circular bacterial chromosome, and here we have point of replication where replication starts, and here is a picture what we might see after replication starts. So we would see here a replication bubble, and this replication bubble would grow in two directions. And if we take a human chromosome or any eukaryotic organism, and human chromosome of course much bigger than bacterial chromosome, it can be hundreds and thousands times bigger than whole genome of the bacteria. And in order to make this replication process in eukaryotes fast, eukaryotes has many points of replication. So where replication starts, and also we may see a bubble here, replication bubbles in each point, and each point would grow in both directions. So this would make this process much faster than if we would have, for example, only one point of replication, and especially if it would grow only in one direction. And here is a large scale picture of the replication bubble. So somewhere over here in the middle would be a replication starting point, and here we may see at the beginning of this replication process two primers would be added, and for example the orientation can be 5 prime end here and 3 prime end here and 5 prime end here and 3 prime end here. So new strand of the DNA grows continuously from 5 prime end to 3 prime end. So that means that new strand of the DNA would grow continuously here and would grow continuously here. And in order for the second part of this replication fork also to grow in this direction, new primers would be added here, and the orientation also would be the same, 5 prime end, 3 prime end, and new strand of the DNA would grow in this direction. And we call such fragments Okazaki fragments. And of course, on the other strand of the DNA, we may have more primers here, and direction of the growth of the new strand would be also from 5 prime end to 3 prime end. So this is going to be 5 prime end and 3 prime end. So that means that here we would have 5 prime end and 3 prime end, 5 prime end here and 3 prime end here of the two original DNA strands. Those each Okazaki fragment would grow in the backward direction towards replication starting point. The overall growth still would be in this direction of the replication fork. And if we would take a look at this replication fork, we also would see the same picture. These Okazaki fragments would grow towards this replication starting point, but overall growth would be in this direction. And as you see, each new strand of the DNA that would grow in two directions would have a leading part and lagging part. Leading part, in which it grows continuously, and lagging part. So this is going to be directions of the growth of new two strands of the DNA, and we can find the same picture in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And next question or statement, DNA polymerase recognizes correct base pairs and incorporates new nucleotides which are correctly base paired to the template. Is it true or false? And basically this is very simple question that asks if we call this enzyme polymerase or not, that extends new strands of the DNA. And the answer would be answer A. This is true. And next statement, the fidelity of DNA replication in E. coli is about 1 mistake per 100 million incorporated nucleotides. Is it true or false? And this is true. In E. coli, 1 mistake happens about per every 100 million incorporated nucleotides. And genome of the E. coli depends on the strain, of course. We can say roughly about 4.5 million bases. That means that one cell have to undergo about 200 replication cycles in order to get one mistake. Or we also can say that we need 200 bacteria that would replicate and would incorporate one mistake in their genome. And is it good or bad? Actually, for the stability of the DNA, this is very good. And such rare mistakes also would be good for the evolution. Imagine that one square centimeter may have millions of bacteria. And that means that hundreds of mistakes can happen in such small space. That's why bacteria very easily can accommodate to changing environment and also can adapt to different toxins that we can use in order to kill bacteria. So this is always continuing war between humans, environment and bacteria that always adapt to the environment, and we try to kill bacteria with new and new variants of the antibiotics. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.